Hello, my name is Martin Boars and I work at PLCnext Runtime Support here at Phoenix Contact. Today we're going to look at a feature that's been introduced in some recent firmware versions for PLCnext Control, and that's the SNMP agent. That's been available from firmware version 2020.3, and so it's also included in the latest firmware version 2020.6. So to demonstrate this feature, we're going to use some software called FL Network Manager. That's from our colleagues in the Fieldline product group here at Phoenix Contact. So I'll just switch to the web page. This is the Phoenix Contact website. And I've navigated to the FL Network Manager homepage. So you can see you can download a demo version of that from our website. Here in the software section, that demo version will run for 30 days, so you can try out what you see in the video here. So when I open FL Network Manager, it actually looks quite similar to PLCnext Engineer. They've used the same sort of design principles here. I'll just create an empty project. Now I have a PLCnext control, an Axialine F2152 controller, connected to this PC that I'm working on. And the first thing we'll do is we'll go to the settings window and we'll scan for our PLC using this software. So we have the choice of scanning using a number of different methods. We have a DCP scan, which uses the discovery and configuration protocol from the PROFINET standards, and we know we can use that for our PLCnext control because this is the way we scan for our PLC when we use PLCnext Engineer. So we just select the adapter that the PLC is connected to. We could also just do a simple ping for the PLC, but we'll go ahead and do a DCP scan. So I'll scan now for the device. And after a short while, we can see that it's detected our PLC. So again, this looks similar to the scan window in PLCnext Engineer. And this is our PLC here. If I just scroll across, I can see there it's an AXEF2152. And what I'll do is I'll right click on this entry and I'll add this PLC to our project. So here in the project tree view, again, similar to PLCnext Engineer, we can see that's been added as just a generic Ethernet SNMP device. So similar to PLCnext Engineer, we have our library over here, and we can see the devices that are included in the library are all the switches and routers from our colleagues in the Fieldline product group. We don't at the moment have PLCs included in here, so that just gets added to the project as just a generic Ethernet SNMP device. So if we open the properties of that device, we can see that all the fields are empty for this device, but we can read these values via SNMP from the PLC, and we can see we get two values back: the description of the device, which includes the PLC part number and serial number, and also just the uptime and integer representing how long the PLC has been running for. So this information was obtained via SNMP. We can also write information back to the PLC using SNMP. So if we go to the project window again, for example, the system name, we can enter, let's say, my PLC into the system name. You can see at the moment the online device has no system name assigned. So similar to PLCnext Engineer, we can apply the project settings to that device. And if we rescan, we see that in the online device, the system name is now my PLC. And if we go back to the settings and we read those again, we can see the name has been read back as my PLC. So this is just a very brief introduction to the SNMP features of the PLCnext control. Any IT network manager will be familiar with SNMP, and so they should find this very useful for managing PLCnext control devices on the network. If you want to go even further with this feature, it's possible to write SNMP scripts, to add new SNMP scripts, and write scripts that will exchange SNMP information with the PLC. You can enable SNMP traps here in FL Network Manager. And if you set up traps in the PLC, those traps can be processed here by FL Network Manager. So obviously FL Network Manager also allows you to manage all your other Ethernet devices from the field line range, and it provides useful features like a graphical sort of view of your physical network topology. So it's actually quite a neat tool for managing your entire Ethernet network. So I hope this has been useful, and please feel free to explore this and ask any questions you might have in the PLCnext community.